go Bulldogs. Let's go Bulldogs. Come on Bulldogs. Don't mess with the Bulldogs. Let's go 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 Bulldogs. Come on Bulldogs. Don't mess with the Bulldogs. Let's go Bulldogs.
Get your game face on. Get your game face, get your game attitude going right now. Don't forget, those are not your friends. Those guys are coming to your house and they're gonna kick down your door. You understand that?
Let's go, coach.
That doesn't sound like you're ready.
Let's go.
Get mad that these guys are coming to your house.
Let's go.
Let's go. No taking breaks. Everybody blocks like a maniac, everybody tackles like a maniac, everybody runs. At the end of the game, you're not going to feel that tired. You're not going to run with a W. When you put that W in your pocket, you're not going to be tired no more.
Now introducing your North Babylon Midget
Blue. Go,
This week, the North Babylon Bulldogs face off against the Plain Edge Bobcats. They enter today with a season record of 1-3. After an emotional game for both players and coaches, the Bulldogs look to bounce back in week 5. Bobcats start off with the ball and a huge chunk of yardage. The Bulldogs' defense appears to be shaking off rust from last week. Bobcats take an early lead. Unable to convert on the extra point, they lead 6-0. The offense takes the field for the first time Pounding the ball up the middle, testing the defensive line, looking for weaknesses in the game. Frustrations mount as number 32, Michael Myrick, and an opposing player miss words and hands. The ball goes back to the Bobcats. They quickly take flight and run to the outside for another touchdown. Bulldogs now trail 12-0. Bulldogs try to answer back with little effect.
Yo, what kind of formation they doing?
The offensive line continues to struggle. Defense is back on the field after just a short absence. Defense holds strong for the first time today and delivers a 4-and-out.
Yeah! block.
The offense, still unable to produce any significant gains, enters halftime in a shutout. The coaches gather the team to discuss their performance.
You're letting them win instead of you fighting and kicking their ass. That's what I see. You guys are laying down. You're allowing them to beat them. They're not kicking their ass. Are they stronger than you guys? Are you scared of them?
Good job on defense.
Emphasizing that the Bulldogs need to hit harder, quicker, and without hesitation. You can't play scared in football. Bobcats, cornered against their own end zone, make a stand and shut the Bulldogs down once again. The Bobcats pounce as they rush for two huge gains. The Bulldogs can't penetrate this offensive line and make solid tackles. Bobcats screech ahead with another touchdown. They now lead 18-0.
Oh, thank you! Thank you!
You're not in the pool again, right?
America.
Light it up!
Down but not out, the Bulldogs continue to pound the ball up the middle. They lose the ball again on downs, and this Bobcat team is once again prepared to take it back. They launch off the line and blast through the middle of the pile, taking it home for another score. Making a statement. Game over. With only a few minutes left in the shutout, coaches are looking for a positive, something to build on. Unable to move the ball, emotions on the sidelines get overwhelming for some.
Don't do that, you don't do that, you big bastard! Calm down, hey!
kids.
You gonna run up on Doug?
Logan!
You better back up and regroup.
Nobody's going for the NFL.
Oh, that kid's gay, man. Come on, relax.
The game ends under a dark cloud.
All right, that's the end of the game. We're going to come on, Bulldogs and Plainview. All right, big congratulations to the win today, Plainview Bobcats. Thank you very much for coming out.
At the end of the day, the Bulldogs are more than a football team. They're a family. Sometimes families fight, but are always there for one another during the darkest of days. Football is life.
See me where you guys lose, I feel bad. You understand what I'm saying? I really believe that. Listen, whoever doesn't come back, doesn't come back. We're gonna coach who's here, all right? You guys been winners, you guys won last year, right?
Let's go.
You guys know how it feels how to win, right?
Let's go.
Just gotta put it together on the field. This week, I haven't been here. I don't come to practice because I have a job, guys. I work at night. That's why I can't come here. But it has nothing to do with the assignments
the problem
that
is
you guys
that
have,
they,
guys.
They make their tackles when they're practicing. Game time, it's like you guys forget.
We're going to make tackles, guys. We're going to do this, man. Just don't quit on yourselves, all right? I believe in you guys. These coaches, every guy who's here believes in you guys. We don't come here just for fun, because we come here because we believe in you guys, all right? Don't worry about the crowd. Don't worry about the parents. We're here for you guys here on the field.
Let's go.
Okay? You guys play. Every week you guys come here and play. That's all I ask from you guys. We got to get it a little bit better, because I feel that we were better than that team. And we got to score, guys. This game's made for score, too. Got to finish our blocks. Finish our tackles. All right?
Let's go.
So come back tomorrow on practice.
Come to practice.
Please come to practice, guys. Ramel, you got sat out of quarter. We could have used you in the first quarter.
Everybody plays hurt.
All right?
Football's a game, you get banged up. You got to play hurt. When you push through that, you get stronger. Your heart gets stronger, your body gets stronger, you get used to it. You learn to accept the fact that your body's going to get hurt playing this game. You have to play that way. Guys, we're coaching you, we're giving you the right tools, we're putting you guys in the right situations. We were there to make tackles. We didn't tackle. We have to go over it again. We're going to keep beating it until we get it.
2 weeks in a row tackles, guys.
We have to do it. You guys have to play the game. At the end of the game, I see tears. You don't like it. Nobody's happy right now. Last year, forget about it, okay? We know what it's like to win this year. Unfortunately, we know what it's like to lose, everybody, and it's not good. It's not a good feeling. But when you're tackling high, allowing the other team to score, allowing an opponent who is not better than you, you're letting them be better than you. You're letting them beat you. It's just you guys got to show up and play. You're not playing. You're running around. You're walking around. You're hanging your head. As soon as they score one touchdown, you guys get the air taken out of you. That's what I'm talking about. You guys are fucking around too much. You think you can just show up and win a game. You're not paying attention to your job. You're not paying attention to what we're saying. You're not paying attention to the guy next to you. That's all you gotta do, man. Listen, practice tomorrow. Bring some energy. I mean, you guys practice like champions every week, and then on game time, you don't show up. You don't show up. So we're gonna find a recipe for you guys to show up on Sunday. I don't know what it is yet, but you know, it's my job to find out. And I'm not doing a good job right now. Nobody's doing a good job right now. We can say whatever we want to say, we can put everybody in positions and all that stuff. We all gotta do better.
We lost just like you guys lost, man.
Everybody played like rookies. So there's not one good player here.
Coach, on practice 110%.
You got anything to say?
Coach. Lincoln, get in here, man. Stand the hell up.
This is the problem. This is the problem.
No urgency.
It took more than 30 seconds for us to get up and tuck somebody. You guys are 9 and 10. You're not 75 years old. Because now, if I was like, guess what, we're going to Dave and Buster's, all of a sudden everybody's right, working out.
No heart, no problem.
And 137%.
And nobody's got not one injury.
And then nobody's hurt then, right? That's bullshit. That's
Eric, good interception.
Guess what? Guess what? We don't get paid for this. You guys are getting paid by learning the greatest game that has ever been played in this country. You're getting paid, and you guys are learning the greatest game that's ever been played. Believe me. If I didn't love it, if I didn't love you guys, I wouldn't be here. Okay? I come from work after 13 hours every day and go straight to the field for another 2.5 to 3 hours.
I quit my job just to make sure I can beat you.
Okay. Listen. You gotta want it. Showing up is not good enough. Put the work in, play your parts out. Alright? Bulldogs on three. 1, 2, 3.